Good morning everyone. This video is for the students of class 11th subject economics. In this video, we shall continue our chapter number 5, that is price elasticity of demand, and this is my lecture number 2 for chapter 5. So, in this video, we shall read two topics. First one, that is slope of demand curve and elasticity of demand. And second, distinct situations of elasticity of demand, or we can say degree of demand. Okay, degree of elasticity of demand. So, the first topic is slope of demand curve and elasticity of demand. Now, the question arises, what is slope of demand curve? Okay, slope of demand curve shows total change in quantity demanded in relation to an absolute change in on price of the commodity. Okay, so what is slope of demand curve? Slope of demand curve shows the ratio between total change in quantity demanded in relation to total change in on price of the commodity. Okay, whereas elasticity of demand on the other hand shows percentage change in quantity demanded in relation to some percentage change in on price of the commodity. So basically the similarity is that they both are the ratio between quantity demanded with respect to on price of the commodity. But slope of demand curve shows absolute change, whereas elasticity of demand shows percentage change. Okay, so this is the difference, that absolute demand curve talks about total change or absolute change, whereas elasticity of demand talks about percentage change. Okay, now have a look on this graph. On y-axis price is shown and on x-axis quantity is shown. Now, when price is falling from 30 to 25, okay, when price is falling from 30 to 25, there is change in price by minus 5. Why minus? Because there is fall in price from 30 to 25. If there would be increase in price, that would be plus 5. Now, when price is decreasing from 30 to 25, our quantity demanded is increasing from 20 to 30. So, by how much our demand is increasing? By 10. Why positive 10? Because there is rise in quantity from 20 to 30, which is shown by DE, and change in price is shown by CD. So what is the slope of demand curve? Slope of demand curve is delta P, that is change in price, divided by delta Q, that is change in quantity demanded. Okay, so what will be the answer? Delta P is minus 5 divided by delta Q is 10. So the answer would be minus 1 by 2. This is slope of demand curve. Okay, see. Now have a look. So slope of demand curve at point C is delta P divided by delta Q. Okay, which I explained you earlier. What is change in price? Minus 5 because there is fall in price. Change in quantity demanded plus 10 because there is increase in quantity demanded, which result to minus 1 by 2. This is slope of demand curve at point C. Now, what will be elasticity of demand at point C? Elasticity formula is given by minus delta Q divided by delta P into P, that is initial price, divided by Q, that is initial demand at point C. Okay, this is a formula which we have read in our last lecture. Now, instead of delta Q upon delta P, I have written 1 by slope. Why? Because we know that slope is delta P upon Q. So, when we will reciprocal it, we will get delta Q divided by delta P. Okay, into P upon Q. Now, when I put the value of slope, which I have calculated above, if I put the value of slope, then I will get this. Okay, P, that is initial price, was 30, Q, that is initial demand, that was 20. Result to 2 into 30 by 20, answer is 3. So what is elasticity of demand? 3. What is slope of demand? Minus 1 by 2. So we observe two things, that while slope of demand is simply the ratio delta P divided by delta Q, elasticity of demand is multiple of two ratios, that is delta Q upon delta P and P by Q, that is initial price divided by initial demand. Okay, so we can conclude that slope of demand curve is simply the ratio of one, whereas elasticity of demand is multiple of two ratios. Okay, and here in the formula of elasticity of demand we use inverse of slope. Okay, inverse of slope of demand. Now we also notice that slope is minus 1/2, which shows that a change in price by 1 unit is related to change in quantity by 2 units. If price is changed by 1 unit, then quantity demand will change by 2 units. Okay, this is the slope of demand curve. Whereas elasticity of demand is 3, which shows that change in price by 1% causes change in quantity by 3%. So we conclude that slope of demand curve is the total change in quantity demanded in relation to absolute change. Okay, it shows total change, whereas elasticity of demand shows percentage change. Okay, also note the point that slope of straight line demand curve is constant at all points, but elasticity of demand on a straight line demand curve is different at its different points. We are not elaborating this point further as it is out of syllabus for the plus one learners. Okay, you have to just keep this thing in mind that on the slope of straight line demand curve, slope is constant at every point, whereas elasticity of demand is not constant at every point. It is different at different points. Now, this is the most important topic. Okay, degrees of elasticity of demand. See, when prices of different commodities change, the quantity demanded of each commodity reacts in a different manner. For example, demand for medicines or needles responds very less to a change in price, whereas compared to AC or DVD player. Okay, see, it is not necessary that if prices will rise, then demand will decrease. Demand can increase also. It depends on commodity to commodity. Okay, so whenever there is price ranges, okay, whenever price changes, it depends on the commodity how it reacts. For example, if the prices of medicines or needles increase or decrease, it will not affect its demand because they are basic needs. Okay, we have to purchase them. But if prices of AC or DVD rises, then we will not purchase them because they are not the basic needs. So it depends on commodity to commodity whether the price will affect its demand or not. So price elasticity of demand can be expressed in terms of numerical value, which ranges from 0 to infinity. Okay, so price elasticity of demand rises between or ranges between 0 to infinity. It can never be negative. Now we shall study distinct situations of elasticity of demand. The first situation is horizontal straight line demand curve and elasticity of demand. Okay, horizontal straight line demand curve. This is also known as perfectly elastic demand curve. This is also known as perfectly elastic demand curve. What happens in it is a situation when even a slightest rise in price leads to zero demand for the commodity. Means if at a particular point of at a particular price there are different demands, but if price rise for even one unit, if there is slightest rise in the price, then demand will become zero. Okay, then demand for such commodity will become zero. But note one thing, that perfectly elastic demand is an imaginary situation. Okay, and we are reading this at micro level, not at macro level. What do we mean by micro level? That it can change from person to person, from commodity to commodity. Okay, these things can change from commodity to commodity. So we are reading about perfectly elastic demand curve. which is a horizontal straight line, which says that if there is slightest rise in price, then demand will become zero. Okay. So see, we know that slope of horizontal straight line is zero because it is a straight line, so slope is zero. We also know that elasticity of demand is 1 divided by slope of demand curve into P by Q. And accordingly, if I put the value of slope of demand curve, that is 0, I will get infinity. So what is perfectly elastic demand? Perfectly elastic demand is infinity, is equal to infinity. Okay. Now see, the second situation is vertical straight line demand curve and elasticity of demand. Okay. It is also known as perfectly inelastic demand curve. Horizontal straight line demand curve was known as perfectly elastic demand curve, whereas vertical straight line demand curve is known as perfectly inelastic demand curve. Now, it is a situation when change in price causes no change in quantity demanded. Whether the price is increasing or decreasing, it will have no effect on demand. See through the graph. Price is shown on y-axis, whereas quantity demand is shown on x-axis. Now, as we can see, price is rising from 2 to 4, 4 to 6. There is no change in demand. Demand is constant, that is 4 units. So, it shows that when there is no change in demand with change in price, then demand for such commodity is said to be perfectly inelastic demand curve. Okay, and keep one thing in mind that this is an imaginary situation. Okay. Now see, we know slope of vertical straight line is infinite. Why? Because there is no limit of the price increase. Prices will increase and but demand will remain same. So slope is infinite. We also know that elasticity of demand is 1 by slope of demand curve into P by Q. Putting the value of slope of demand curve, we get 1 divided by infinity into P by Q, which result to 0. So, elasticity of demand in perfectly inelastic demand is 0. Okay? Now, have a look on situation number 3, that is rectangular hyperbola demand curve. This kind of demand curve is also known as unitary elastic demand. Okay, this kind of demand is also known as unitary elastic demand, where percentage change in quantity demanded is equal to percentage change in price. Okay, where percentage change in quantity demanded is equal to percentage change in price. See, this is the hyperbola curve. Okay, this is the hyperbola curve. Below this curve, all the rectangular areas, this one, and this one, all these areas are equal. Okay, and what does these rectangular areas shows? These areas shows total expenditure on the commodity. Total expenditure on the commodity, which shows that there is constant total expenditure no matter what the price is. Okay, means a percentage change in price is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded. Now we will study about elastic and inelastic demand. Demand for a commodity can be categorized either as elastic or as inelastic. Okay, demand for a commodity can be elastic or inelastic. When it will be elastic? When elasticity of demand is greater than 1. When elasticity of demand is greater than unity or 1, okay? At that case, demand for a commodity is elastic. What does this mean, greater than 1? This shows that percentage change in quantity demanded is greater than percentage change in price. See through graph. On y-axis, price is shown and on x-axis, quantity demanded is shown. If you notice, then change in price from P to P1 is less in comparison to change in quantity demanded from Q to Q1. Okay, from the diagram you can notice that there is less change in price in comparison to quantity demanded change. Okay, so this is the case when the demand for a commodity is highly elastic. It is greater than 1. Now, what would be the examples? In what kind of commodities the elasticity of demand is elastic? Like AC, DVD. Okay. If the price will reduce, then their demand will increase. Okay. Now, when demand is inelastic, okay, demand is inelastic if ED, that is elasticity of demand, is smaller than 1. If it is smaller than 1, then elasticity of demand is inelastic. What does this shows? This shows that percentage change in quantity demanded is less than percentage change in price. Okay, see, change in quantity demanded, percentage change in quantity demanded is less in comparison to percentage change in price. Okay, so our demand curve would be this. So these were the different degrees of elasticities of demand, or you can say distinct situations of elasticity of demand. Okay, where elasticity of demand is equal to 0, infinity, is equal to 1, smaller than 1, or greater than 1. Okay, in our next lecture, we shall study further. Now your homework is, you have to read lesson number 6, price elasticity of demand, and you have to do given question. What is the degree of elasticity of demand in case of the following demand curves? Straight line parallel to x-axis, straight line parallel to y-axis, or rectangular hyperbola curve. Okay, basically you have to explain distinct situations of elasticity of demand. Now, in the last lecture, I gave you some numerical problems. Here is the solution for those numericals. The first question was, when price is rupees 10 per unit, demand of a commodity is 100 units. As price falls to rupees 8, demand expands to 150 units. Calculate elasticity of demand. Now, see the solution. Original quantity is 100 units. New quantity demanded is 150. As it is increasing, so my change in quantity would be positive 50 units. Positive why? Because there is increase in demand. Original price was 10, new price was 8. As price is decreasing, so my change in price delta P would be negative 2. Now my ED would be, formula is delta Q divided by delta P into P by Q. Now remember one thing, I am not using minus sign with the formula of price elasticity of demand. Why? Because I am using minus sign with delta Q or delta P. Okay? So my answer would be 50 by minus 2 into 10 by 100, that is minus 2.5. Now the second question is, when price of sugar is rupees 5 per kg, its demand is 50 kg. When price rises by 5 per kg, its demand falls by 10 kg. Okay, so initial price is there, initial demand is there. Price rise by 5 means new demand, new price would be 10. Its demand falls by 10, that is delta Q. Calculate the elasticity of demand. So original quantity is 50, delta Q is 10. So what would be the quantity? New quantity would be 40. Okay, as it is falling, so delta Q is minus 10 because quantity demanded is decreasing. Now original price is rupees 5, it has increased by 5, that means change in price is 5 and new price is 10. Now again I have used minus sign with delta Q and delta P, as my delta Q is negative, so I will not use minus sign in the formula. Okay, so the answer would be minus 0.2. Note one thing, that minus sign is used only for showing inverse relationship between price and demand. Okay. So it's better if you use minus sign at one place, either with delta Q or delta P or with the formula. Third question is, when the price of good X is 5, the consumer buys 100 units of goods X. At what price would he be willing to purchase 140 units of good X? The price elasticity of demand for good X is 2. See, original quantity is 100 units, new is 140. So there is increase in demand by 40 plus 40. Original price is 5. New price we don't know. And change in price, that is delta P. Now see one thing. The price elasticity of demand would be delta Q by delta P into P by Q. What is elasticity of demand? 2 given according to the question. 40 by delta P. Suppose my delta P is negative. Okay, suppose, assume. That's why I am not using minus sign in the formula. So delta Q is 40 by delta P into 5 by 100. That is delta P is rupees 1. Now when delta P is rupees 1, if I will subtract rupees 1 from original price, the new price would be rupees 4. So new price is 4. Now the demand for good falls to 240 units in response to rise in price by rupees 2. If the original demand was 300 units at the price of rupees 20, calculate price elasticity of demand. See, as it is said that demand falls to 240, so new demand is 240 and original is 300. As it is falling, so change in quantity demanded would be negative, that is minus 60. Rise in price is 2, original price is 20. As rise in price is 2, so the new price would be 22. Now elasticity of demand, as I have already taken minus sign with delta Q and delta P, so my price elasticity would be delta Q by delta P into P by Q, that is minus 60 by 2 into 20 by 300, that is minus 2. Now the demand for a good at rupees 10 per unit is 40 units. Okay. Price falls by 5. If price elasticity is minus 3, calculate the new quantity demanded. Original quantity is 40. I don't know new quantity, so I don't know delta Q. But price is 10. Price is falling by 5 and new price is 5. Now if price is falling, that means demand will increase. So my delta Q would be positive. See, price elasticity would be delta Q by delta P into P by Q. So what is price elasticity? Minus 3. Delta Q by 5 minus 5 into 10 by 40, that is delta Q is equal to 60 units. Okay, means as price is decreasing, the quantity demanded will increase. It means new quantity would be original quantity plus change in quantity. What is original quantity? 40. Change in quantity is 60. So what is new quantity? 100 units. Okay.